Good morning students, this is Pawan Kumar, lecturer in electronics, MVNJS and RVR College, Melkipuram. In this video, I have to discuss universal gates. This video is belongs to second BSc electronics students in semester 3. First of all, what is the universal gate? A universal gate is a gate which can implement any boolean function without need to use any other gate type. That means, what is mean by boolean function? Boolean function is a combination of variables which is logically added or ANDed logics. That means universal gates refers to the combination of gates by implementing boolean function. We need to convert a logic gate to universal gate. We have to use universal gate then, which can perform different types of gates. Here NAND gate and NOR gates are universal gates because these two gates are used for simplifying or implementing the basic logic gates expressions like OR gate, AND gate and NOT gate. The advantage of AND and NOR gates are economical and easier to fabricate. So this is the main advantage. NAND and NOR gates are economical and easier to fabricate. And the basic gates used in all ICs, digital logic families. You know about the digital logic families. RTL, TTL, DTL and TTL. These are the different types of logic families. In this logic families, you have to use these NAND and NOR operations. You have to divide the logic gates in three parts. First one is basic logic gates. AND, OR and NOT gates are the basic logic gates. And second one, universal logic gates. NAND, NOR gates are the universal logic gates. And other logic gates are also available. And XOR gate, that means exclusive OR gate. And XNOR gate. So in this class, I will discuss about what is the universal gate, why it is called universal gates. University of NOR gate. So we have to convert three basic operations by using this NOR gate. A two input NOR gate has only one output, y equal to, for example, y equal to a plus b whole bar. If these two input NOR gate is converted into three basic gates, that means AND, OR, NOT. We have to use only NOR gates to realize and implement the NOR operation, which is equal to NAND, NOT and OR AND operations. These are the university of the NOR gate. You have to convert first NOR gate into NOT gate. Look at the symbols. You know about the NOT gate. NOT gate has only one input, which is converted into one output. That means A is, output is A bar. That means complement of A. In NOR gate, you have two inputs, but which is converted into NOT gate. If the two inputs are combined as treated as a single input. That means the two inputs NOR gate has converted into two input lines are connected as a single line, which is as a single input NOR gate, NOT gate. then output will be A bar. Hence, the NOR gate acts as a NOT gate. In this way, we have to convert NOR gate, which is equal to OR gate. You know about the OR gate. The output expression or Boolean expression of the OR gate equal to A plus B. Now we have to convert NOR gate into OR gate. You require A plus B from A plus B whole bar, which is easily to remove the complement of A plus B, because we have already converted NOR gate into NOT gate. That's why this converting gate is used for removing this complement. Hence we have to convert NOR gate into OR gate. You can see the symbols, circuit symbol. You have to convert NOR to OR. So you have to write and draw the NOR gate A and B. The outputs of the NOR gate equal to A plus B whole bar. You have to convert NOR to OR, then which is to remove the A plus B whole bar and complement of the bar, complement of the previous output. That means NOR output. Hence, you have to already convert it from above symbol. Hence, it is converted into A plus B. This NOR gate acts as a OR gate. Now, let us third condition. NOR gate acts as a AND gate. We have to implement NOR gate, that means A plus B whole bar, which is equal to A dot B. How it is converting, OR logic is converted into AND logic. You know about the Boolean laws, that means De Morgan law. A plus B whole bar equal to A bar dot B bar. In this De Morgan law, we have to convert OR logic into AND logic. So we need to, for De Morgan's theorem, for this conversion NOR gate to AND gate operation. Hence, we have to, first of all, we have to convert individual bars of variables. That's why we have to draw first symbol, which gate we have to convert NOR gate to as a NOT gate. That symbols are, you have to use A, then output will be A bar. And again, second variable B, then output will be B bar. These two inputs are connected to the NOR. Hence, A bar plus B bar whole bar. From De Morgan's law, A bar plus B bar whole bar. That means A plus B whole bar equal to A bar dot B bar. Here two bars are cancelled, then A dot B is our required answer, which is equal to AND operation. In this way, you have to convert AND NOR gate into three basic logic gates. Hence, it is named as University of NOR gate. We have to also look at the same conversation in this manner. First of all, NOR gate which is converted into NOT gate, and second one, NOR gate is converted into AND gate, and third one, NOR gate is converted into OR gate, and second one, NAND gate is a universal gate. NAND gate, we have discussed later, we have to convert NOR gate into three basic logic gates, hence it is a universal gate. And same manner, NAND gate has also converted into three basic logical operations, like inverter, that means NOT gate, AND gate, and OR gate. You know about the NAND gate. If we have to consider two input NAND gate, for example, we have to consider two input NAND gate. It has two inputs, for example, A and B. Then output will be A dot B whole bar. This is the NAND gate. But we have to convert, first basic gate, NOT gate. NOT gate has a single input gate. Hence, we have to require If you to connect our two input variables are combined with a single variable, treated as a single input variable. Hence, the output will be complement of a input. Like which is converted, NAND gate is which is converted into NOT gate. Hence, this process you have to connect two inputs are combined with a single input, considered as a single input, then which is converted into complement of a input. Hence, NAND gate acts as a NOT gate. And second one, NAND gate acts as a AND gate, which is easily to simplify by the NAND to AND, because you have know about the NAND output A dot B whole bar, but your required conversion is required to A dot B. So you have to remove the A dot B whole bar, then which is converted into AND logic. Hence we have to remove the bar, we have to use NAND gate acts as a NOT gate. That's why A and B are the two inputs, then output will be A dot B whole bar, which is converted into A dot B double bar. Double bar is, will be cancelled equal to A dot B. NAND gate acts as a AND gate. In this way, we have to convert NAND gate acts as a OR gate. That means A dot B whole bar equal to A plus B. How it is converting OR gate into AND gate into OR gate, I mean AND logic into OR logic. You know about the Boolean laws, there is mainly De Morgan law. A dot B whole bar equal to A bar plus B bar. This is the De Morgan law. This De Morgan law convert AND operation to OR operation. That means AND logic to OR logic. By this, using this De Morgan law, we have to convert NAND gate into OR gate. Our required equation A plus B, but we have NAND output A dot B whole bar. So we have to convert A dot B whole bar into A plus B. So our required equation A plus B, which is from De Morgan laws. By using NAND gate, which is acts as a NOT gate, we have to consider input A equal to A bar, then B equal to B bar. So these two inputs are combined with the NAND gate, then output will be A dot B whole bar. A bar dot B bar dot, sorry, A bar dot B bar whole bar, which is equal to, from De Morgan law, A bar dot B bar whole bar, which is equal to A bar plus B bar. Here A double bar plus B double bar, which is double bars are cancelled, then output will be A plus B. These are some remaining basic logic gates, and remaining gates are converted into NAND gate from remaining gates. For example, NAND gate acts as a NOT gate, and NAND gate acts as a AND gate, and NAND gate to OR gate, and NAND gate to NOR gate, and NAND gate to XOR gate, and NAND gate to exclusive NOR gate. These are the conversation from one gate to another. That is the reason from by using the NAND gate, which is acts as a three basic binary logic operations, and remaining gates also. Hence, the NAND gate and NOR gates are called as a universal gates. So this is a video for universal logic gates. These logic gates we have to use different types of applications. Like, for example, NAND gate. NAND gate application, that means example, we have device failure alarm system. That means if you have to use any digital system, if it has failure, then it will automatically intimate. How to intimate the fail to alarm system, depending upon the alarm. Look at this diagram and follow the points. When all the fans are working, the input to the NAND gate is 111 and the output is low, 0. That means when all fans are working here, the input to the NAND gate is 111. That means if the fan is working, then output will input will be 1. If in any of the three fans is off, the working fan will be, that means the fan is not working, the input will be 0. If the inputs are high, that means all fans are working properly, then output will be 0. That means there is no on condition for alarm. If any one of the fan stops working, the output of the NAND gate becomes 1, which activates alarm. Because NAND gates, if the one of the input is low, that means which activates the output. This logic depends upon the NAND. This application will be used in failure alarm systems. And next, we have to discuss NOR gate application. Applications of washing machine and control. You have to use different types of universal gates in different applications, and one of the application is washing machine control. This is very useful for our daily life. What is the need for NOT gate? What is the function of NOT gate? We have to discuss here. If the machine is lid is open or the water is top is below certain level or the machine is overloaded. That means in NOR gate, we have to, first of all, we have to discuss what is the NOR logic. The NOR gate is a combination of NOT gate plus OR gate. You know about the OR gate. OR gate output is equal to A plus B. The complement of OR gate is equal to NOR gate, hence A plus B whole bar. That means you have to observe OR gate. If the one of the input, for example, 0 plus 0 equal to 0, 0 plus 1 equal to 1, 1 plus 1 equal to 1. If the one of the input is 1, the output is also 1. This is equal to OR gate. This is complement of their outputs. If the one of the input is high, then output will be high, which is equal to OR gate. If the one of the input is high, the output is also low. This is the NOR gate. This certain logic is depends upon the our required application, like our washing machine control. What do you need? If the machine is lid or open or water in the tub is below certain level or the machine is overloaded, weight of the water and cloths in the tub is above certain limit, the output of the corresponding sensor is set to 1, producing a 0 at NOR gate output, then switches the machine off. You have to, some limitations are there in washing machines, because you have to load the cloths in proper weight and proper way. You have to load the overweight of the cloths, it indicates the overload. Otherwise, you have to use the intaking water, we have to put the intake water in certain levels, because our tub is required waters. We have to fill the our tub required water. The output of the corresponding sensor is set to 1. That means you have to, water levels or cloths are overloaded, then output the sensors in the washing machine. What is the sensors you have to use in washing machine? If the cloth is overloaded or certain water levels are crossing our the water level, we have to indicate a sensor to set to 1, producing a 0 at NOR gate output. If the one of the input is 1, then output will be also 0 because it is a NOR gate operation. And that switches the machine off. That means if the output producing 0, then automatically switch the machine is off. Our washing process is interrupted because our machine is overloaded or our water levels are, certain water levels are increased. In this controllers, we have to use microcontrollers in washing machines. This is the best application for NOR gate. So these are the universal gates. In this class, we have to discuss two different types of universal gates, NAND gate and NOR gates. Why it is called the universal gates? These two gates are using for, these two gates are for basic logic operations like AND or NOT. Why it is, so it is called the universal gates. These universal gates are used to very easy to implement and easy to fabricate the for integrated IC technologies and logic families. There is a number of applications in our daily life like switching actions, because it has only operating only binary digits like 0 and 1. Hence 1 is considered as a on condition and 0 is considered as a off condition. You have to control any one of the device or any one of the circuit by using these operating conditions. We have to use NOR and NOR gates. These are the different types of applications. We have to use NAND and NOR logic. So thank you. Thank you, Ananda.